I get asked a lot what machine that you should get when you're trying to start your ultrasound journey. And it's really important to consider a few things. First, how are you going to use it? What kind of setting do you work in? How much money do you have to spend? And then finally, what's your IT infrastructure? Let's start with how you're going to use the ultrasound machine. Think about what sorts of scans you need to do. Are you going to be looking at joints, musculoskeletal, or are you going to be doing what I do, which is more focused on the chest, as well as maybe looking at neck veins or veins in the arm? This really matters because it depends on whether you need a machine that has many different probes or if you can get away with just maybe one probe. Next, you really want to think about your clinical setting. If you're in a clinic or an ICU, everything's on one floor, you can push a big cart-based machine like this around. It's not too bad. But for someone like myself, who's working in the hospital, many different floors, I really need something small that I can put in my pocket, right? I want to keep this machine on me at all times. This, I can just throw in a little bag over my shoulder, and I always have it with me. Next, you need to think about price. The price of ultrasound machines, a little bit like buying a mattress, it can be hard to know exactly how much they cost. Machines like this, you have to get from a medical distributor, and it's actually pretty hard to find out exactly what the price is. But I can tell you larger cart-based machines are usually in the tens of thousands of dollars, whereas some of your smaller pocket-based machines are going to be well under $10,000, and some for as little as two. So again, when you're thinking about your budget, you really want to take that into consideration when you're choosing a machine. The last thing is to consider talking with your IT guys. If you're part of a large healthcare system, there's certainly a move to start integrating the point-of-care ultrasound studies that physicians like myself do and pull those images into the main IT infrastructure, right? And not every machine will be compatible with your IT system. So it's certainly worth, before you go spend a lot of money, to talk with your IT guys to figure out what machines that you can actually connect to the greater infrastructure. Now, I am going to make a recommendation to all of you, and that is, since you're starting your journey, you really want to make sure that you have a chance to practice. And the analogy I usually like to make is, you know, if I was working with trainees and I told them, here's your brand new stethoscope, I want you to lock it in a closet down the hall. And every time you need to use it, here's a key, you can go unlock it and pull your stethoscope out. Guess what? You probably wouldn't listen to the heart or lungs very often. It's the same thing with ultrasound. If you have a big cart-based machine that's locked up down the hall, you might use it when you really need it, but chances are you're going to find ways to not go down the hall and take the time to pull this machine out. When I'm rounding and seeing patients, I have a machine like this in my pocket, right on my body every time. So just like my stethoscope, it takes no extra effort to just pull the machine out and get a quick scan. Right? Not only is this going to hopefully help me to take better care of my patient, but it's actually going to allow me to practice and keep my skills up. So I'm going to recommend to any of you that work in a hospital to make sure you have something that will allow you to scan frequently and with as few barriers as possible. Now, once you have a machine, you need to make sure you know how to use a few basic functions. So I want to make sure that we review the functions that every ultrasonographer should know, anyone who's doing point-of-care ultrasound. You really need to know how to adjust the depth, how to adjust the gain, how to freeze, take a measurement, and then record a short video. Let's go ahead and get started. So let's go over a few functions of the machine. First, I'm going to go ahead and grab an image here just so we have something to look at. And now we're going to go over the functions that I think are most important for you to know. We need to be able to adjust the depth, okay? Every machine will have depth. And let's say I want to bring it in a little bit. I want to make the beam not go quite as deep. I press the up button, or I press the down button, and I can look deeper into the chest, okay? Pretty straightforward. Gain is another function you may find yourself needing. To be honest with you, most of the modern machines have great what we call presets, right? I'm in cardiac mode right now. I'm taking pictures of the heart. I usually don't need to adjust gain very much. But if I did, this adjusts the sort of brightness of the image, right? And so I can dial it way up, and everything gets brighter, okay? And I can dial it down, and everything gets darker. Again, to be honest with you, for most scanning these days, the presets are good enough. You don't need to change the gain very much. Now, it's going to be really important that all of you know how to freeze an image so that you can take a measurement. So frequently, the freeze button, it'll be labeled freeze, or sometimes they get fancy, they put a little snowflake here, okay, and that lets you know it's time to freeze. Now, a lot of people, when they start out, they're trying to time their freezing just right. They see what they want, and they jump for the button. I want all of you to know, every machine, it keeps a loop of the recent images. So I can hit freeze, and now I can just grab this, and I'll just slide it back in time, and I can get to any recent image I want. So I don't need to dive for the button. I just hit the freeze whenever I want, and then come back to the machine, back to the image that I wanted to see, all right? And then the last thing I want to show you how to do is how you can record a video. And so for this one, on this machine, there's a little video camera, and I just click that, and it goes ahead, it records a video clip. And for most machines, it's preset, a 3-5 second clip. Every time you hit it, it's going to grab another 3-5 second clip. There are some machines where it acts a little bit more like the camera on your phone. You hit the button, and it'll just keep recording until you hit stop. But most of these machines, it'll just grab a quick loop. That's going to be really important. As a point-of-care ultrasonographer, we're much better at looking at videos because that's usually how we're doing this in real time. So I find, especially when I'm working with trainees, I tell them to go grab video loops that we can go review together. And I find it's usually much more useful than the still images. The still images, though, are going to be important for when you want to take measurements.